Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Free Script Sundays. This week I've got a new mic, so do let me know how's the audio quality this time. And while you are at it, please also hit the like button and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any future updates. And without wasting any more time, let's get straight to the add-on. This week's add-on is called Bake a Node, and it allows you to quickly bake the output of any shader node into an image texture. So you can use it for nodes like Bevel, which does not work with Eevee, or you can use it to bake the output of complex node setups which take a lot of time to calculate and can be performance intensive. So let me show you how it works inside Blender. So I have this very basic node setup as an example. It's just a Bevel node attached to the normal input of the principal VSTF node. And if I switch the render engine to Eevee, you will see this does not work because the Bevel node is not supported by Eevee. And in this case, you can use this add-on to bake the output of this bevel node into an image texture. So let's do that. Make sure the node is selected and click this bake node option. You can set the resolution and samples as you want. And let's replace the original node with the baked output and click OK. And you will see it automatically bakes the output of that node and replaces the original node with the baked output. And it looks quite good. And let me show you another example with the edge mask node from the Rand Tools add-on. And similar to the bevel node, it also does not work very well with Eevee. So let's switch to cycles to see how it actually looks. And now let's bake its output to an image texture. Select the node, select the object, click this bake node option, replace, OK. And it will take some time. And as you can see, it looks very similar to the original. It looks a little off because the quality was 2K and not that high. But you get the point. So that is it for this week's episode of Free Script Sundays. The links for the add-on, as always, are in the description below. Also, version 2.0 for the synced modifiers add-on is out. The links for that are also in the description. So go check them out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.